All right, folks, so this is Garmin's Swim 2 Sportswatch, and what they did here is they crammed all the advanced swim functionality that you'd normally find in a multi-sport watch like the 4 or 945, and they put it into a smaller and simpler package that's also a lot cheaper. Now, although the Swim 2 is aimed for swimmers, being Garmin's least expensive watch that has both pool swimming as well as open water swimming, it still comes with an outdoor running profile, an outdoor cycling profile, as well as a generic cardio workout profile that's kind of a catch-all for anything else that you want to do. Now, if the Swim 2 looks familiar, it's because it's basically a 4 or 45 that's just tailored for swimming. The big difference is that the Swim 2 is going to have an open water swimming profile, and then the 4 or 45 does have a couple other workout profiles that aren't available in the Swim 2. But the other big difference is that the Swim 2 pairs with external heart rate straps that are designed for swimming, like the HRM Swim. Now, you actually don't even need an external heart rate strap for swimming because the Swim 2 will attempt to collect your wrist heart rate in the water, and we'll see how accurate that is here in a second. So before we get into the sport profiles on the Swim 2, I did kind of want to go over some of the more general stuff that you're going to get with the Swim 2. For daily activity and health tracking, you'll get heart rate that's collected 24/7 through its onboard wrist-based heart rate sensor. It can measure your stress levels on demand, as well as gives a body battery score, which is basically a score of your energy levels throughout the day, as well as how well you recharge overnight. Then you'll also get daily activity tracking, like any activities that you did that day, like this bike ride that I did right here, your intensity minutes for the week, which is how much time you've spent doing vigorous activity, your steps for the day, as well as a breakdown of your calories for the day, including a breakdown of active and resting calories. The Swim 2 also provides sleep tracking, where it'll give a breakdown of your deep, light, REM, as well as the time that you've spent awake. You can see this in a graph format, and then you can also see your respiration rate as well as your movement throughout the night. You'll also be able to receive one-way notifications, including text and mail notifications, but just note that these are just one-way notifications. You can't reply from the watch itself. You'll also get weather information that's pulled from your phone, including a forecast of 4 hours ahead, as well as the next 4 days ahead. And then you can also see events from your calendar for your phone. And in regards to battery life, I was able to get about 4 to 7 days out of it, depending on how many outdoor activities I used using GPS. So basically, if I was running and cycling a lot outdoors, I would get, you know, closer to 4 to 5 days. And then if I wasn't, I got up almost up to a week. The Swim 2 also comes with an outdoor running profile, an outdoor cycling profile, as well as a generic cardio profile. And all of these perform pretty much exactly the same as the 4 or 45. And I already did an in-depth review of the 4 or 45, which I'll leave a link for that video in the description below as well as up here. But for pool swimming, in terms of the options that you have with it, you can preload workouts onto the watch that you can set up in Garmin Connect. You can take a critical swim speed test. You can customize the data screens as you wish. You can set up different alerts. You can set up your pool size in either meters or yards, and then you can turn on stroke detection either on or off. And we'll see how well this works here in just a second. You can also set a countdown to the start of your swim, and then you can also enable or disable auto rest periods, which is designed to automatically detect when you stop your interval and not include your rest time into your interval time. And we'll see how well that works here in just a second. But after your swim, for the metrics that the Swim 2 can collect, you'll get your total time, distance, estimated calories burned, pace, as well as your swell score. Then there's going to be more advanced metrics like strokes, average stroke rate, average and maximum speed, as well as a breakdown of your total moving and elapsed time. Then in regards to lap detection, I found this to work flawlessly, counting each interval where it will detect your stroke type, gives a breakdown of lengths per interval, time per interval, average and best pace, swell score, heart rate, stroke metrics, and even calories per interval. Now, if we scroll back over to the left, though, here's where we can see the breakdown of swim versus rest time. And this was done automatically without having to press the lap key, which you can do, by the way, but I found the automatic rest detection to work pretty well. It takes about 1 to 3 seconds for the Swim 2 to detect when you're going to be taking a rest period. So it's not exact, but it's pretty darn close. As an example, right here, after I finished an interval, I manually pressed the lap key on the Phoenix 6 Pro, which is on the right. So that's the exact time I stopped that interval. What you'll notice is that the rest timer on the Swim 2 is about 2 seconds behind the manually lapped Phoenix 6, and then you can also see that reflected in the interval time, which is about 2 seconds off. So, like I said, it's not perfect by any means, but it's fairly close. And now on to heart rate. So the Swim 2 can collect heart rate data in the water using its onboard wrist-based heart rate sensor. It's not going to be spot on with an external heart rate strap, but what I found is that it's sort of close, what I would call trendable. So what you'll see is that it follows along pretty closely to an external heart rate strap in this example right here. There were 2 occasions where I found that the Swim 2 wasn't quite getting the elevated heart rate that the external heart rate strap was getting, but again, I think for the most part, it's not super off. And lastly, the Swim 2 also does come with an open water swimming profile, and that activity profile is generally only found on multi-sport watches like the Forerunner 945. And unfortunately, I haven't been able to test that because it's been winter in Colorado, but my good buddy DC Rainmaker, he has already tested that in his in-depth review, and I'll leave a link for his article in the description below, but spoiler alert, he found it to be pretty darn good. So the Swim 2 is going to be a great little sport watch for those of you looking for that higher-end swim functionality that you'd find on more advanced multi-sport watches, but just in a little bit cheaper package, but it still does have the workout profiles like outdoor running and cycling, so you can still do other things with it. Anyhow, if you did find this video interesting or useful, make sure to hit that like button down below and also subscribe to the channel for plenty of more sports tech videos coming soon. Thanks for watching.